Here we are on another episode of Nokia Makes Too Many Phones, exemplified by the fact that this is called the Nokia 6.1. They can't even use whole numbers anymore because they used up all of their first 10 numbers last year. No joke. Either way, the Nokia 6 won my most durable phone of 2017, so hopefully with this 6.1, it can hold its own in 2018. Let's get started. At first glance, the Nokia 6 and 6.1 are pretty similar. Last year's 6, the one with the map of Finland on the back, is slightly taller, but the 6.1 has a longer camera lens housing, which really accomplishes nothing beyond the aesthetics and distinguishing between the two. Both still have the same size 5.5-inch screen. Speaking of which, it's time for the scratch test. I have a series of numbers laid out on the phone which correspond to the different levels of Mohs hardness. Since Nokia is running the very common and familiar Gorilla Glass, this version is 3, we already know that we should start seeing marks at a level 6, and deeper grooves at a level 7. Different parts of the phone are outsourced from different manufacturers, and Corning Gorilla Glass is probably the top of the line when it comes to cell phone glass, no matter which version it is. This is the black and copper version of the Nokia 6. It also comes in a white iron configuration, but the important thing is that it's made from metal. The volume button and power button are also made from metal. And the top of the phone, next to our favorite buddy Jack, is also metal. I asked on Twitter the other day how often people still use their headphone jacks, and out of 14,000 people, an impressive 75% of you responded that you use a headphone jack at least every week. The SIM and SD card tray is also metal, and down at the bottom of the phone we have a microphone hole and a USB-C charging port, which is a step above the micro USB port from the Nokia 6 last year. The 8-megapixel front-facing camera is protected by that same Gorilla Glass 3, and the recessed earpiece grille is still made from that same wire mesh stuff as previous Nokia models. It is secure though, and won't be falling out on its own. The bottom of the screen also has no physical home button this time around. The main camera lens on the back with its elongated camera lens is made from glass and does keep the singular 16-megapixel camera protected from scratches. The flash for some reason isn't under the glass, it's exposed, but that might be to keep the flash from refracting through the glass into the sensor when it's being used, so it's not a big issue. The fingerprint scanner is located on the back panel below the camera lens, slightly recessed. I'll give that a little scratcheroo to simulate a few years worth of abuse. But in normal Nokia fashion, it still works just fine. It's not invincible like we saw in the OnePlus 6, but this phone is still way cheaper, so we'll let it slide. For the back panel, if you remember, Nokia is from Finland, and a little known fact is that the Finnish national cross-country ski team, which as far as I know is the only hobby over there, they were the first people to ever use a portable heart rate monitor, which was also invented in Finland in 1977. And now we use it all the time in watches and cell phones all over the place. So thanks, Finland. One thing I am worried about is that the glass screen of the phone has no plastic layer buffering it against the metal. Two brittle objects against each other isn't a good thing, especially during drops or bends. We'll find out soon enough. The burn test is next. The 6.1 has a 5.5-inch 1080p screen, and the 16x9 LCD lasted about 10 seconds under the flame from my lighter, which is perfect timing because that's about how long it took me to say that sentence. The pixels did start working again though, which is nice of them. And now the bend test. Going from the strongest phone of 2017 last year to another zero flex device this year, Nokia is over there producing some of the strongest phones known to man. And this 6.1 is no exception. For the price, this build quality is pretty incredible. It's a shame that the phones aren't more available here in the United States. The lack of a plastic buffer between the glass and the metal frame is a non-issue since there's also no flex, but it might become an issue if you're the type of person who drops your phone regularly. The first thing to give out or break won't be the metal, it'll be the glass, since there's no cushion. So a case and a screen protector are still always good ideas. It gets a thumbs up from me. Come hang out on Twitter if you want to take part in the next poll question, and thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.